In this video, we'll go through how to set up a free blog using Hexo static site framework. By the end of this video, we'll have a blog that is hosted on GitHub for free using Hexo JS. So by the end of this video, we'll have a blog just like this human theme. We'll be using this human Hexo theme to create a website for free using Hexo.js and hosting it on GitHub. So let's get started. So first, to create a Hexo blog, we need to have Hexo installed on our system. So to install Hexo.js on our system, we need to have a Node.js already installed. If you don't have a Node.js, just go to nodejs.org and then browse to either download 4.5 version or current latest version 6.6. Either one is fine. Just go to other downloads, and then if you are on Windows, just download this depending on your system architecture, download the Windows installer and then install it. If you are on Linux and if you want to install Node.js via package manager, just click on this link. And then depending on your Linux distribution, you can type these commands to install Node.js. For example, if you want to install 4.x version, you can type these commands. And if you want to install version 6, then you can type these commands, just like this. After installing Node.js, and when you go to terminal and type node-v, you should see the version that you are using. So currently I am using latest version, which is 6.4. Okay. So after installing Node.js, and if you have already installed Node.js, then just go to hexo.io site, and then you can see that to install Hexo.js, we just need to type npm install hexo cli minus g. You see here, npm is a command which gets installed when we install Node.js. So npm stands for node package manager. To install Hexo, just type npm install and then minus g for globally installing Hexo, and then hexo CLI, hexo hyphen CLI. So once you type that, node fetches the Hexo.js framework and installs locally on your system. It may take few seconds depending on your network. Once it's done, you can verify it. So to verify whether Hexo is installed, just type hexo-v. When we get a response like this, here we see hexo CLI 1.0.2. That means Hexo is installed. So let's create a directory named blog and then cd into that blog. And then once we are in the blog folder, we can type hexo in it to initialize that folder as a blog. You see hexo downloads the default theme and basic scaffolding and basic structures will be done when we type hexo in it. It initializes that folder as a hexo blog, so which installs default folders, and then it also comes with the default theme landscape. So it comes with a message saying start blogging with Hexo. If we list the blog directory, we can see that it comes with config_config.yml, and then node modules folder, which contains node dependencies and package.json file, and then scaffolds folder. source folder and themes folder. Source folder and config folder. Config folder basically contains the overall site configuration and settings, and source is the directory where we write our blog post. And themes themes directory contains the themes that we are going to use. So now, so open this folder in your favorite editor. Here I am using Atom. You can see that config.yml contains some configurations about site title. Let's say my Hexo site beautiful site. Here you can configure things like site name, site subtitle, description, and the author of the post, and language. By default, it's by default language English. If you are in language, author, time zone, and your site URL. Let's say myblog.com, and this is the URL of the permalink URL of the post, like your site /2016/09/20/ my first post. And these are the basic configuration settings that we may need to. Here you see that currently the site is using landscape theme. So themes, we just have only one thing called landscape, and in source folder we have a post folder which contains the deep post, which is hello world. So let's write a new post to write a new so let's write a new post to write a new post just type hexo new and then post and then your post name, my first post. If you type this, it will create my first post.md in your post folder. You can see that we now have my first post.md in our post folder. So this is the title of the post, and here you can write whatever you want. Here this is the content area where we can write anything about me. So once it's done, we can check it in our localhost by typing hexo server. So now hexo is running at localhost at port 4000. So we'll just go to that folder and see. You can see that we have currently two posts. One is hexo hello world and another one is my first post, which we just wrote. If you click on this, you can see that this is the content and this is the title that we have. You can also notice that we have a path that we just saw in config.yml file, which is the permalink year, which is 2016, and then 09 month, and then day, and then the title of the post. So once everything is fine and you have tested it on your local host, then you can type hexo generate to create a static site. So So when we type hexo generate, we'll get all these HTML files and CSS files in a public folder. This public folder is the one that we need to push it to GitHub or wherever you want to host your site. So we can host our site and GitHub for free. So in this video, we'll push this GitHub public directory to GitHub. So to host a blog on GitHub, you need to have a account on GitHub. You can just create it by going there for free. After creating it, just create a new repository with the same name as your username and then github.io. Suppose if your username is Apple, then your repository name should be apple.github.io. This should be it. Like currently my username is Moobit, so I am creating a repository name moobit.github.io, my exo blog, and then create a repository. So once you create a repository, you will get the SSH or HTTPS path which we can use it to push the blog. Now what we need to push to GitHub is just the public directory. So just go to public directory and then here initialize git by typing git init. Now git add git add all and then commit and then commit the code that we have. So my first exo blog post. So now we have committed the code. We need to push it to GitHub. We need to add git remote. You need to add the repository part to git remote add origin and then paste the code like this. Now you can push the code to GitHub by running git push origin master. It pushes the code to github.io, to this repository. When we reload it, we can see that the folder is created here. Now when we go to moobit.github.io, we can see that our blog is here. You can see that on GitHub moobit.github.io we have a blog just like that we have on local host. That's it guys. Now let's change the theme. This theme is not good enough. We can change the theme by let's change the theme to human. Human is a good theme, which is a human is the nice theme, which is a redesign of WordPress theme human. So you can download it here. You can download it by going it to Hexo human theme human. I'll add these links under the description. Please go through it and then download the Hexo human theme to your themes folder. So let's say I'll download either you can download it or clone it. Here I'll download it just for simplicity's sake. I'm pasting it here and extracting it here too, and then I'm renaming it to human. Once I'm done with it, I just go to config.ml file and then human. By the way, don't forget to replace your URL to whatever URL that you are using. Here, right now, I am using GitHub URL. Later on this video, I'll explain how to have a custom URL like mydomain.com. So I created this thing. Now let's see how it renders. Hexo server. Once you copy the human theme and renamed it, just go to this human folder and also rename the file config.ml.example to config.ml. So after that, let's serve the Hexo to check how is it rendering. Now if we go to our localhost and see, we have a site that is very, very beautiful. Here we have two posts and our post content, and these are the dates and everything. It's good. Once it's done, then I'll again generate the, so once we have changed the theme, we'll generate it again. So we'll go to public folder, git status, git add all, git commit, change the theme to human, and then git push origin master. Now if you see,
hi, in this video